guys, and welcome to another episode of the Trackmania podcast. And once again, it's the pleasure of having the guys that were in the last episode. Today, we'll do a little prediction episode of who we think will do best in 2018. We'll predict four categories: it's Player of the Year, Team of the Year, Breakthrough Driver of the Year, and Story of the Year. If you don't know who my guests are today, I guess you have to check out the first episode of this channel. My guests today are Scotsman and Nelky. And I allowed you guys to introduce yourself in the first episode, and I will let you introduce yourself in this episode as well. Scotsman, can you tell them who you are and what you do in Trackmania?
Well, what can I say if you don't already know me by now? But been an A&E, been playing in that team for about 2 years now. I've been a streamer for about half a year, something like that. So, yeah, you'll usually find me playing competitions and streaming them as well. So, pretty much all I can say about myself.
Yeah. Nelky, who are you and what do you do?
Well, I am the shoutcaster of Venture Esports, and I'm just, in general, an amazing guy. Yeah. And I love to shoutcast matches.
Yeah, that's it. Before we reveal who your official picks are, can you sort of describe how your thought process has been? Are you going to go for a ballsy picks or sort of like the safe picks? Nelky, I'll start with you.
It depends on the category for me.
Okay, so half and half maybe?
Yeah.
Oh, and Scotsman, ballsy picks or safe picks?
Yeah, same for me. We might go for some safe picks so people don't rag me in social media again. But we might go for some surprises here and there just to keep people interested.
Okay. And before we start going into each category, we have already passed 1 month in 2018. Are that going to affect your picks?
Yeah, well, definitely, because, I mean, we've already started off with, we had the end of ESL, and we've got TMPL Season 2 already starting off and well underway. So, yeah, I've definitely took that into account in some of the predictions I've made.
And Elke, what about you? Are you ignoring it or are you taking it into account?
It depends also on the category. For some, I did adjust it a little bit, and for some, I haven't, so...
Okay, let's get into it. Player of 2018. Who is going to dominate the scene, take home title after title from the big events? And I want to ask you, Nelky, first. Who have you picked and why?
I picked Expert Peck, actually, for the Player of the Year.
Why?
I expect him to do many, many, many amazing things this year. After his performance in the last year as well. And in the year before, I just expect him to do once again very, very good, and I expect him to win.
Yeah, that's your pick. Scotsman, who have you picked and why?
Right, so this one's going to be a safe pick. I mean, I promised I would at least have one of them, but I'm going to go for the tried and true. We're going for Carl Jr., who's representing Zerator. So that's my pick. I would say with Carl, to be honest, I kind of look upon past as well as how he's performed throughout this year already. So, for example, the reason I'm picking him is, of course, and hopefully there's going to be a Mania Planet World Cup back, and I anticipate with, of course, him not being the most recent champion for the first time in a very long time, that hopefully will be motivated for going forward for solo competitions. So imagine this will be his bounce back year. He'll be looking to prove a point, especially over PAC and likes Pro League. So there's a lot of events I feel he'll thrive upon, a lot of solo-orientated events, TMPL, of course. We'll have of course, a Zerator Cup, hopefully, as well this year. And hopefully we'll have a Mania Planet World Cup of some sorts as well. So a lot of space for Carl to thrive. If he's got the motivation and the drive the same as he's had all these other years, then I think we can see great things, as always, from him.
That's your pick. My pick of Player of 2018 is going to be the same person I picked for 2018. It's going to be Massa. I think he will take home at least one LAN event. If it's Gamers Assembly, I don't know. If it's Gaming Winterfest, I don't know. But at least one of them. And I also think if he's highly motivated, he can take home the Trackmania Pro League. And as always, he performs well for his team. And that brings us over to who's Team of the Year? Who's going to win the most amount of titles? Who's going to have the best performance of overall players? Scotsman, who have you picked and why?
Well, my primary pick for Team of the Year, I must admit, has been E-Corp, as I've been very impressed with their performances going through and how they've kind of developed very fast, going with the players they already have and bringing back some the kind of old French guard, as it were, the likes of Omnipots and people like this coming back and bringing them within the same lineup. And they've just went from strength to strength, of course, with the previous ECLCPS reaching the final and only falling very short in a very, very close match with Lioncast. And of course, this season, they ended up going all the way and taking out Venture in the final of this CPS. And I can only see them getting better from here. Of course, as I said, they've got an extremely strong lineup. Of course, a kind of fusion of the original E-Corp lineup, as well as the almost the entire strength of the Against All Authority lineup coming in. So I can only see them, as I said, getting better from here on out.
Yeah, for sure. At least a contender, one of the big contenders. Nelke, who have you picked and why?
I have multiple, actually. It was
very hard for me.
Spicy.
That's not safe. No, I know. I also want to go for the E-Corp team.
Yeah.
Basically, for the same reasons. For the same reasons as Scotsman just gave you, and the second team I also want to. I want to go for is Venture Esports. They have proven to be a very strong lineup. And I haven't picked Expert for this category because the other teams in the scene, they have shown lately that they are very able to defeat Expert. I kind of hope to see that it's not going to be Expert for once.
So you pick two teams. That's kind of boring, but I understand you. Let's see. My team of the year, it's the team of 2017. It's Team Expert. I believe they have the best lineup. I believe if the team is fully trained and compete in the team events, they will take home the title. And I'll also take in consideration that they have the most amount of players in Trackmania Pro League, which I see as a team performance, and I think the players there will do pretty good. Now, let's move over to maybe a more fun category where we have different options. It's Breakthrough Driver of the Year. It's sort of like a new named category, but it's the same as the new phase of 2017. The definition of this category is that it's a player that sort of have been in the average pack of players and taken a step to being a top contender. Nelke, who have you picked for Breakthrough Driver of the Year?
Venture Dutchie.
Why?
He has been performing outstandingly so far, especially in the ESL. He has been so extremely strong. I know that he is going to Gaming Winterfest. Not quite sure if he wants to go to the Games Assembly as well. But I think if he has the same performance, if he has the same performance in a LAN tournament, then he can for sure reach the Grand Final and maybe even win it. If he does, then there's a great year ahead of him.
Yeah, that's for sure. Scotsman, who is your pick for Breakthrough Driver of the Year 2018?
So again, this might be a bit of a safe one. I'm not apologizing for it though, but we're going with Troll of Lioncast.
Why?
Troll coming from, he's not in any way to say he's been a middle of the pack player. Of course, he's been a Dignitas trialist over the times, and he has always been a good player for Lioncast throughout the years he's been with them. But obviously, going over the recent CPS seasons, we've really seen him step up and take it to the next level. He was credited with quite a good bit of Lioncast's success through their ESL CPS 18 triumph, and as well going forward in his first few matches. Again, this is one of the ones I took as well from 2018. His first few matches of TMPL, he's already showing a very good level, and you're seeing people commenting on the fact that he is impressing his audience when he does show up. and when he is transforming his team skills, when he's playing very well in team events, he's also showing that he's extremely adept and he's extremely good at solo events as well. So, I mean, going forward, if we're only going to see that in TMPL, it'll be a shame. Hopefully, of course, we see him going to some LAN events. I'm not entirely sure what his aspirations are and that kind of side of things, but regardless of what he goes for, as long as he keeps his motivation, I can see him being considered within possibly one of the top players in the world by the end of the year.
Yeah, that's for sure. My breakthrough driver of the year is also a player from Venture. It's a Dutchie, but his name is Wagentje. I believe he's been known for maybe the best hunter in the game, at least short maps. And now I think he's ready to take the step to carry Venture, but also to do well in LAN events. I think he will go to Gaming Winterfest, and I think he will already put an upset there. Let's move over to the last category, and I will be surprised if we have the same pick here. The story of the year. What is going to affect 2018? When we look back at the year, let's say in 2020, how are we going to remember 2018? Scotsman, what is your story of the year, and why? Nice.
So we'll go for a bit of a curveball here. Something I'm looking forward to for 2018 is now the organization LANX coming into the fold. They're organizing a lot of new events. Of course, I believe we've had a few members of the Trackmania scene picked up and taken into their organization. They've showed a lot of motivation to be setting up LAN events throughout France and throughout the full year. So hopefully they manage to make a splash this year. Hopefully they manage to get good coverage of their events and such, good amount of players going and things like that. And I can picture if it goes successfully for them, then they might have a big impact on the Trackmania scene going forward. And certainly, hopefully it will be a story to remember by the end of the year as to the impact they've had for us.
Yeah, that's a good and funny pick, and also an optimistic pick, a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
Nelky, what is your story of the year?
My story of the year, it was the hardest one for me to pick. And I was a little bit creative with it.
Okay.
My story of the year will be that every tournament, another team or another player will win. I just love to see the variety in like winners, and lately we have seen such a high level from so many teams, and I think there's a pretty good chance that every tournament another team will win.
Yeah, that's for sure, and also for solo events we might see different players win each time.
Exactly.
My story of 2018 will be Serator moving into esport. Why? Because Trackmania is dying to see some big coverage. And a big spotlight we get is from Serator. He can recruit new players, but has not really moved into esport yet. But now, already in the start of 2018, Carl Jr. joined. And I think if he decides to build up a team, I think his fan base might get more interested in seeing the team matches, even though it's not might be from the team of Threader, but will also affect the other teams. I think eventually that will help the game grow a lot. And this can be a year that we remember as Threader moving into the esports side of Trackmania. That concludes the four predictions of 2018. When we are going in December or New Year's for 2019, do you think any of us has at least one correct pick, Scotsman?
Well, I certainly hope we've got at least one correct pick. Otherwise, it's not really saying a lot of good things for us. Yeah. I mean, some of our picks are optimistic. Some of our picks are, of course, it's always hard to do predictions, you know, just due to the nature of them. I mean, we don't have that much information to go on. But I'm optimistic. You know, I'm looking forward to some good things, and I hope some of these ring true. More because that means I'm right than anything else. But yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing what my picks, E-Corp, Troll and such. I'm looking forward to see what they can do.
Nelky, are you confident that your picks will beat mine and Scotsman's picks?
Always. I'm always confident about it. Yeah, it's there are so many players and there are so many teams and there are just so much like. There are so many things happening in a year.
Yeah.
It's so hard to pick. So hopefully at least one of my predictions will it will come through, but we will just have to wait and see.
Yeah, and I guess we will do a little recap episode once the results from the 2018 votings are out. Let me just mention that I did this with Shumi last year. I picked 4 picks. I didn't hit one even single correct. So let's hope this year will be the first one. Guys, this has been a pleasure having both of you in both of the episodes. And I want to give you sort of like, what do you say, a place to tell people where do you follow you. Scotsman, where can people get to know more about you and see more of your content?
Well, of course, my Twitch page, the main thing, of course, I'll be streaming from, and I'll be doing recordings of which I'll put up on the YouTube channel. Of course, the links will be available in the likes of the Twitter page, and I just recently created a Facebook page as well. They'll all be at TM Scotsman, so you can always check me out there.
Melky, where do people find you?
I am also on Twitch, of course. I'm on Facebook as well. On Twitch, it is twitch.tv/Nelky, and on Facebook it is also /Nelky. I might be wrong about it, but I'm not completely sure about my links actually. And I'm also on YouTube. Also, I will be casting the Truckmania Pro League on Twitch for the next couple of weeks. I will also stream the Gaming Winterfest as well, so we have great things coming. And I cannot wait to cast it.
Yeah, that's it. It's been a pleasure, guys, as I said. And guys, hit subscribe button because there will already be an interview posting next week with a profile from the scene. And I guess you'll be dying to hear from him. Bye-bye, guys. See you until the next episode.
See ya.
Bye-bye.